It's time to mask those troubles away. Hey, Power Director peeps, how y'all doing out there? My name is Malik, and I'm back on your screen with more Power Director love. That's right, the Power Director love you're looking for from Power Director University. Today I'm going to show you how to use motion masking using PowerDirector and ColorDirector to add a mask that will allow you to remove backgrounds or remove items from your videos. So let's jump off into the software and make it happen. Here we are in PowerDirector 15 Ultimate. The motion mask is used to select an object in your video, and then you can select to remove that object or you can select to remove the background. And I'm going to show you just how to get that done. As you can see, I have a clip in a timeline. So I'm going to left click on this clip, and then I'm going to go to Fix Enhance, and then I'm going to go up here to Color Director. Now, Color Director is a program that you have to buy separately from Power Director, or you can buy the Power Director suite, things like that. But it costs you additional, I think, like $130. So if you find that it's useful to you, then you can get this program. It does a lot more than just doing the motion mask. It does color correction, color grading. It has global color correction tools, regional color correction. It's a whole bunch of stuff in there. So check it out. The link will be in the video description so you can learn more about it. And if you want to, you can also use that link to purchase it. If you do, it'll help out the channel to continue to make videos for you. But if you don't have ColorDirector and you don't want to get it, still watch the video and see how it all gets done. So I'm going to click on ColorDirector. And as you can see, I have ColorDirector 3. Right now, I think it's on version 5. ColorDirector 5 is the current version. So if the interface looks a little different, which it shouldn't look too different, but if it does look a little different, that's why. I have ColorDirector 3, and the current version is ColorDirector 5. So now that we have it open here, what we want to do is we want to make sure that we select the regional adjustment tool section. If it is closed, all you need to do is click here and open it up. And then once you're here, you want to select motion tracking mask. Now that I've clicked on that, we have a section here. It says mask, new, brush, eraser, size. It's got a whole bunch of different things in here. But you'll notice if I move my cursor over the video that now my cursor turns into a brush with a plus sign in the middle. All right. So if I want to use a smaller brush, I can just come over here to size, hold down my left mouse over the slider. And now if I slide to the right, it shows how big the brush will get. If I slide to the left, it shows how small. So you can change the size of your brush here if you wish to do so. If it's too big or too small, do that there. So I'm going to bring my brush back here, and I'm going to select this individual because this is the individual I want to focus on. That looks pretty good. Now there is a section here I got a little bit of the background that I don't want. So if I want to, I can go here and click on eraser. And now you see that my brush has a negative sign in the middle, so it's going to remove instead of add. So I just hold down my left mouse, move it across the part that I want to remove, and then let go of my left mouse. Now if you're getting message pop-ups during this time, you might get messages saying, hey, you can hit the motion tracker button and things like that. Just click on never show again and okay until those messages stop popping up. So I'm going to go back to brush. I see some more here that I want to make sure I get. And that's pretty good. So now I have a pretty good mask established. So what I want to do is come down here and click on start motion tracking. So now it starts motion tracking, and as it moves, if I see an error anywhere, like here, I saw, hey, this isn't in here. I could just press the start motion tracking button again, and it'll pause it, and then I can make whatever changes. Once again, you might get another message saying, hey, if you press this, that, the other, you know, read the message. If it's important to you, great. If not, don't worry about it, and click on never show again. But now that I made that adjustment, I click on play again, and it moves forward. Now, I can do this throughout and fix any errors whenever I see them. And I would recommend that you do that if you're doing this for one of your videos. But since I'm just making a tutorial, I'm not going to keep pausing it over and over again. I'm just going to let it play all the way through and track what it tracks. All right, so now that it's finished tracking, you'll probably get another pop-up saying, hey, it's going to stop if it can't track anymore or whatever. That just means that it's done. All right, so you want to click on Never Show Again, click on OK. And so now, as you saw with this tracking, there are still some issues with the tracking. So if you didn't stop it or pause it and fix the tracking, then you can go frame by frame and fix the tracking. So at this point, I'll just go ahead and use my brush and say, hey, let's fix this. And it'll fix it. I go to the eraser here and erase a little bit of that. It'll fix that. And then I can go back or forward a frame. So I'll click on back. And if I see another error I need to fix, I fix that. And I just keep going frame by frame and fixing these as they go. Now remember, if you were pausing it and fixing things as you went along, you're going to have less frames to fix. But I just let it play all the way through. So I probably have each and every one of these frames I have to fix. So I really recommend that you pause it when you see errors. It'll give you less to fix later on. All right. But we know that my mask is not perfect because I'm doing a tutorial, so I'm okay with that. Now, say you made all your adjustments, you went frame by frame, you fixed everything you needed to fix. Now, if you want to remove this gentleman and you want to replace him with something else, then you're not going to do this next step. But if you want to remove the background, then the next step is to click on Invert Mask. So I'm going to click on Invert Mask because I'm going to remove the background. So what that means to you is that whatever is red is what you're going to be removing. So now that I have the area selected that I want to remove, I need to change it all to one color so that I can use the chroma key in PowerDirector to remove that color or the background. So what I want to do is come down here to the tone section. And under the tone section, I want to move my exposure all the way down. And I want to move my brightness all the way down. Because I'm trying to get this background to be all black. And so the next thing I want to do is change my contrast and bring that all the way up. So that looks really good. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to scroll down to the color replacement area. So under color replacement, I'm going to click on the eyedropper and I'm going to select the black. And then I'm going to come down to the color replacement section and I'm going to go to new color. I'm going to click on this little box here. And I'm going to select green so that it changes the color I selected, which was the black, to green. And I'm going to click on OK. And now it's not all green, so I need to come over here and under the original color area, there's a section called tolerance. And I'm going to slide this all the way up. And now everything is green. Now, if you feel that your edges are too sharp, you can scroll all the way back up to the mask section and you can feather it if you want to. Feathering it, as you'll see, will just make the edges a lot softer. At some point, it'll begin to remove the edges, of course. I'm going to move it all the way over to the left because I'm fine with the sharpness right now. And so now I'm going to go up here to the top and I'm going to click on back to be taken back to PowerDirector. Now I'm going to close out this Fix Enhance area. And you can see now that it brought it back. It brought it back with the green around the individual. And so now I want to go ahead and select a clip that I want to use here. And I'll just drag this above that section. And now I need to go to the clip. So I'm going to left click on the clip. And I'm going to go to Designer. And then I'm going to go to PIP Designer. I'm going to make sure that I'm on the Properties tab. And then I'm going to select Chroma Key. And I'm going to click on the Chroma Key box. Then I'll click on the eyedropper to select the color that I want to change, which of course is green. And I can click on OK. And now you can see I have the individual here in the scene with the new background, looking all lovely with all my little errors in there that I included. Yes, of course, because I didn't do frame by frame, but you get the idea, people. There you go. Motion masking in PowerDirector 15 Ultimate and ColorDirector.
All right, PowerDirector peeps, I want to thank you so much for watching this video all the way through to the end. It truly means the world to me. Now, I want to go ahead and give a shout out to one of our PowerDirector University subscribers, Mark Blasius. Mark Blasius makes YouTube videos on traveling and fun stuff. So, if you want to see some fun stuff or you want to see some travel, head on over to his channel, watch a couple of his videos, and if you're feeling what he's dealing, make sure that you subscribe. If you want to get a shout out like Mark Blasius did, make sure that you head to the video description and fill out our shout out request form. And if you want to make a tutorial request, you can also find our tutorial request form in the video description as well. Now, there's a few things I need you to do for me. The thumb, the one that's pointed in the upward direction, click on it. It lets people know that the content in this video was good and that they should watch it too. If you got any comments, questions, you just want to chop it up, leave those things in the comment section below. And last but not least, make sure that you smash that subscribe button. And then after you do that, click on the bell. When you do that, you receive notifications every time I upload content to YouTube. And that way you don't miss out on any of the learning and all of the fun. Thanks for watching. We'll see you again soon.